Hey guys, okay, so I think this is going to be the last video on this topic. I can't promise anything, but I think this will be the last video on this topic. And I want to kind of talk about the prestige of both professions. Because there is, both fields now have a certain amount of prestige to it. I know I began this series of videos talking about the stigma and demonization of the fields. So I think it's a good way to end the topic by talking about the exact opposite. By the prestige of it. I think one could argue that, you know, psychology definitely has much more prestige because it's much more well-known field. Like, if you're a psychology student, you could kind of, you know, you can have this discussion where you meet new people and it's like, oh yeah, you're a student. Yeah, I'm a student. Like, what are you majoring in? I'm majoring in psychology. I'm like, okay, that's cool. Like, people will understand what that is. You have no problem with people not understanding what that major is. So that's the first thing, you know, people know what it is that you are doing. You know, a lot of times I meet strangers and they're like, oh, okay, like, what do you major in? Like, oh, I majored in social work. They're like, social work, that's interesting. Meaning they don't know what it is. They have no idea what social work is. I get that response a lot. And I think that's a response that psychology students will probably never get, if ever. You know, it's going to be a very rare experience for them, for a person they're talking to doesn't know what psychology is. You know, it's the study of the mind. At least that's kind of the basic thing. Social work is just like, what? Like, okay, well, you know, and I noticed this a lot in the comments to my videos, especially the most discussed video on my channel is still, and I think it will continue to be so in the far, far future, but it's still my video regarding, you know, about my student loan, the video that's like, I owe Citibank $105,000, I still get so many comments, still do, on that video, and some of the comments that kind of, you know, respond to me having that because I majored in social work, respond about social work, like, you don't need a degree to be, you know, to social work. You know, it's like, man, you wasted so much money on a liberal arts degree. You know, things like that. Both of which are really, really incorrect. But it's just interesting because not a lot of people have any idea what social work is. I didn't have any idea what it was when I applied to NYU, actually. So it's kind of weird circumstance that I ended up being a social work student. But that aside, you know, I still do think there is a certain amount of prestige with being a social worker, especially because it's an easy path. The path of a social worker is easy to be licensed. You know, you get your master's, and you take an exam, and you become a LMSW. You know, you have a licensed master social worker. It's the same thing with nursing. You know, registered nurse. You graduate from a nursing school, you take an exam, you become a registered nurse. And RN has certain prestige over other kinds of nurses, like CNAs, nursing assistants, and what is it, LMPs? No, I think LMPs are nurse practitioners. I'm not sure. But there is a certain amount of degree with getting a social work, you know, being more established in the social work field. Whether you're demonized or not, like being a social worker in foster care, you know, people will give mad props for that, you know. I give mad props for that. Foster care system is broken, but the fact that you are, you know, you're working there, it's amazing. And I think when we start considering social workers, I think it really depends on what field of social work you're in. School social workers, not many people, I get the general sense that not many people really know about it that much. It's kind of a thing that's there, you know, and once they learn about it, like, they respect it. Like, yeah, that's awesome. You work with, you know, students in schools. Students really need that kind of, you know, mental and emotional support from professionals. That's really cool, which is, like, the same thing a person would say about school psychologists. So, yeah, there's that. You know, and I think there's varying levels of just kind of disgust and sense of astonishment depending on the field, you know, like, for example, prison social workers. I think that's pretty controversial. Some people are like, that's awesome. Some people are like, oh man, like, whoa. You know? Especially social workers that work with ex-felons or ex-convicts. So they come out of prison, they need services. It's social workers that provide such services oftentimes. Not always, but oftentimes. So that in itself is an interesting thing to consider, because a lot of people, you know, they get really angry, especially in America, where justice is framed as, people who committed the crime got the punishment that they deserve to get. That's kind of how justice has often been framed in the history of this country. With that framing, especially with that kind of framing, it's hard for social workers who are working with ex-convicts to have a sense of prestige. Yeah, very hard, because what are they doing? They're serving clients who murdered, who raped, who stole, who got addicted to drugs, who sold drugs. Yeah, we work with drug dealers, so we serve them. You know, social work is a helping profession. We help them. So try to get that concept. This is why social work is such a controversial field. Depending on the field of social work, social workers help sometimes. Some social workers, a good number of social workers help murderers. They help rapists. Now, this is why, like I said before, and when I started talking about this topic, there's a lot of stigma, a lot of demonization of the field. People hate social workers, even though they may not necessarily know what it is that social workers do. They have this negative view of social workers because, hey, social workers do that. And me personally, I would actually, like, you know, I think that's an interesting career path. You know, that's an interesting field to get into. So I haven't, you know, I'm starting to kind of cross off kind of the social worker, kind of the social work field that I don't want to be in. So far, I crossed off hospital social work. I don't want to be a hospital social worker. And I don't want to be in foster care. Don't want to do foster care social work. So I'm starting to cross off like the things I don't want to do. But that's more of a personal thing. It has nothing to do with like whether I hate those social workers. I just think like that's not for me. You know, it's kind of you know, when you become a doctor, you kind of know which kind of doctor you want to be. You know, I don't want to be a plastic surgeon. You know, but I want to be this kind of surgeon. You know, I want to be a general surgeon. I don't want to, or I want to be a neurosurgeon, or I want to be a general practitioner doctor. I want to be a doctor that focuses on, you know, the stomach. I forgot the terminology for that. You know, I want to be a pharmacist. You know, different fields of being a doctor, but still being a doctor nonetheless. It's kind of like that with me. You know, I'm still trying to figure out what kind of field of social work I want to be in. So prestige with social work, I think it really is so different depending on which field of social work there is. But I think it's just considering the fact that there are many kind of similar degrees. You know, there's psychology, there's social work, there's counseling, there's public health, not to be confused with health administration, because that's a totally different field altogether. That's more businessy. Public health is more, you know, there's public administration, which is more policy, which is very similar to social work. But you compare social work to those other kind of degrees, and social work degree has much more prestige. It's much more established. There is the National Association of Social Workers, which has this kind of, I don't know, at this point it's kind of being territorial with this prestige, you know. I think the field of counseling is trying to really establish this prestige, but there's, you know, the field of psychology and the field of social work are kind of lobbying so that, you know, counseling remains at below the fields. I don't know. It's old geezers who are fighting over their prestige. That's pretty much what it is. But anyway, the reality is that social work does have much more prestige and flexibility than certain other fields like public administration or public health or counseling. So that's not to diss anybody who is studying those fields. It's just, I'm just telling you the reality of status quo. That's just reality. If you, if you want a job in the nonprofit sector that is about social services, it's actually easier to get a job with the social work degree than it is to, you know, have a degree in counseling. Just statistically, it's true. That's not to this, but counseling still has very low unemployment rate if you get a master's degree in it, when you get licensed in it. So that's not to worry you guys. It's just this is just comparison's sake, you know, just compare and contrasting. Psychology, the prestige is there once you get a doctorate. You know, I think that's the problem with psychology. Like, you need a doctorate to get anywhere in psychology. Seriously, if you have a bachelor's in psychology, you're not really gonna get a job. The sense of prestige you're gonna get doesn't really exist. If you have a master's in psychology, like, that's pretty awesome, but you're still not gonna get, you know, prestige is not there, and getting a job is still hard. So for psychology, once you get a doctorate, like, you're better set. But now you have that many amount of school, that many years of school, and you have a lot of debt too. Both social work and psychologists will end up with a lot of debt if they go to like private universities like I did. But social work has a lower unemployment rate, much lower. It's considered as one of the lowest rates. It's not as low as like something specific like agricultural technology development major. Oh my gosh, that's like 0.9% unemployment rate. So it's really, really low. But it's in the it's comparable to the unemployment rate of something like education. 2%, 3%, about that much. Psychology is crazy. So psychology field, the unemployment rate is like 16%, 17%. And I think largely it's because if you don't have a doctorate, you're not going to get anywhere. And once you do get a doctorate, the competition is fierce in psychology field. So I think that's part of the reason why like psychology major has such a huge unemployment rate. But once you do get a doctorate, you're a doctor. I mean, prestige is obvious. A doctor in psychology compared to a master's in social work, like, the prestige is there. And more, like I said, if you're studying psychology, there's no one that's going to be like, what the hell is that? You know, there's no one that's going to be like that. They're going to be, okay, you're studying psychology. That's cool. You know, what are you planning? What kind of thing are you planning to do with your psychology major? That would be the next question, which is common. With social work, the question is just like, social work, huh? What are you studying? Like, what is that? And then you kind of start to explain, like, so, like, is there jobs that come with that? Like, what do you do? Like, do you really need a degree to be in social work? Yes. Yes, you do. Just to get that out of the way. Yes, you do. But anyway. Yeah, it's one of those things you actually do have to also have to be licensed for a lot of the aspects of social work, but let's not get into that. So, yeah, that's kind of what I wanted to just talk about in regards to prestige. I think also, like, media, you know, there's a lot of prestige with social work, with psychology in the media. You know, you see a lot of psychologists in movies, in TV shows. They're more established. It's kind of rarer to see a social worker in a TV show or a movie. I just recently started watching Orange is the New Black, and there's a LMSW in there. And it's just like, oh my gosh, it's one of the administrators of the prison. And, you know, he's kind of portrayed as this, it's interesting how he's portrayed, but you see, that's like the norm of how social workers in something like a TV show or movies are portrayed. And I would think maybe it's not too far from the truth. But it's like every time social workers are portrayed in any movie or TV show, it's not in a good way, you know? It's rarely ever in a good way. I feel like I'm trying to think of a movie that actually portrayed social workers in a good way. I'm not sure if Finding Fisher counts. I think that was more of a psychology therapist, but it could have been a social work licensed therapist. It's based on a true story. I think that's like the only time. I haven't seen Precious, but I haven't watched Precious, but I did hear from some people that it doesn't portray social worker in such a really negative light. I'm not sure. I haven't watched it myself, so I can't make that judgment. But yeah. Anyway, that's me talking about this whole topic. Well, hopefully this is the last. I feel like you guys are probably hoping this is my last video on the topic. It probably is. But there might be something more to talk about in regards to this topic. I don't know. But yeah, thanks for watching. And if you guys have any comments, questions, whatever, feel free to leave them. Yeah. Take care.